to the food festival. You know, we're talking about the food festival. Yeah. So, Christopher, I'm talking to Christopher, okay? So, Christopher, if you're watching this, Christopher Ramirez, if you're watching this, I'm telling you that I already told you that we were about to go to the food festival. So, yeah. Know your things, you're a smart kid. Know your things, okay, man? Okay? Got my varsity jacket on. Got my Diggy's World hat right here. Diggy's World, I wish we could get another one with the real logo, but we don't got no time because we're late. It's like, what time is it, guys? 2:30. See? 2:35.
To Garden State Plaza Mall. We here for this food event and Diggy was telling y'all about. So we here ready to eat. Ready to eat, bro?
Yep. All
got pot pastas, Callahan's, Waffle Bar.
Waffle and Coke.
Yeah. You ready?
Popcorn for the people.
You excited?
Yeah.
You gonna eat up? Huh?
Alright, here, I'll give you a special bag.
Yes.
Are you the special bag?
Yes.
Like
I know, it's really not crowded. I'm looking like all the stations.
This is a banana pudding place. They have really good
food. Almost a food.
Power Power's coming up.
Right now?
Yeah.
At 3?
Yeah. It's not that common.
Yeah. This is nice.
This is so cool. Wait, what are we going to start?
Different backdrop
setup. You
can
take pictures of your food.
Got it.
Different backdrop. That's why it's called InstaYUM.
What about we start with something short, like maybe some popcorn?
Start with what?
Maybe we can start with something short, like maybe some popcorn real quick.
Okay. Yeah, while we wait for
it. I'm starting to grow the spiders.
Where? Yeah, I want those too. Come on, let's just get it now while we wait for it. What's that? Captain Crunch burger that you're showing? Unbelievable.
Yeah. Yeah, Jimmy, you can take this. Oh, sorry, bring the mic.
Go ahead. Yeah, baby. Oh my God. Oh my nuts, baby, New York. What you get, Diggy?
Oh, I got some buffalo chicken.
So what do we have here? Can I see your sticker? What we have here is whole knots, which are garlic knot slider. This is Cadence, which is a buffalo chicken garlic slider. And Keith and I both got the chicken parm. When I say they smell like garlic, they are gone. So
good. This is just for a guy.
And now we're about to go over to see the Bow Power, which I came here to see. I'm so excited! I'm like so excited, like a kid in a candy store right now. You guys just don't know. I love food. I love to eat food. I love to smell food. I love to drink drinks. They have a bar, they have food, and they have the Bow Power. What more can I ask for? And I won these tickets. Thank you, NewJerseyFamily.com.
He eats a lot of food and he works out too. And that's his girlfriend.
I'm
going
to get together and get it too.
Yeah. So, yeah, we're going to collab with them too.
At our next session, Blake is going to be doing a panel discussion about how to go viral because his stuff has gone totally viral. It's crazy. He eats massive amounts of food. He's super thin. It's wild.
Okay guys, so the Bow Power just went up. Now I'm walking around. I'm gonna eat some more. Obviously we only ate one thing since we've been here, but if you see all these cool things around me, these are like their Instagram stations that they set up on InstaYUM. So this one is like with the inflatable, see that inflatable chair with that awesome background. And that background are paper plates. So cool! And we got some other ones set up here. This is cute. So you can sit your drink here that looks, that's like half empty, and take a cool picture. You know? Sit your food there. This is like so awesome. We got ice cream cones. So cool. Hi.
Are you vlogging?
Yes. Oh, she's a vlogger?
Oh, yeah, this is a
Latino
farmer.
Hi, I'm Dominique. Nice to meet you from Diggy's World.
Diggy's World?
Mm-hmm. No. We're vlog. We're fairly new. My son, he just went to the bathroom. He's an actor. He's 8 years old.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so we just like, we vlog his life so others can see exactly like what we're doing and how we do it. Because you know, a lot of people, they just see people when they become famous. They don't see how they became famous or how they became celebrities, you know?
Like, I feel like I want to know the how process.
So, exactly. Especially as a child actor, we don't. A lot of people ask this question like, oh, how did you get him on commercials? How did you do this? But now you get to see.
That's so cool.
Yeah, so follow us. Yeah. Let's exchange some info.
That, how was that garlic nut sandwich?
Cool.
Got it. How was that garlic nut sandwich?
So amazing. And I want to be a caterer.
You do? That you can make a living off of that, you know that?
Thank you so much.
No, you drop me love. You know, why are you not eating?
I just want a drink.
The drink's a fine, just gonna eat.
Is it good?
Yes. Just the rice.
That is what happened. The rice is good. Nice and crunchy. Oh my god. How's the crab?
Crab is good.
It's like cheese on it? What is that? Is it egg?
I think it's egg. It's egg with cheese. Egg with cheese on top of the rice. The rice, the crab burger.
The crab is good. Your rice is my favorite part.
Rice is my favorite part.
It's like crispy, but like still soft.
It's really like a, like it's made like a toasted bun.
Oh my god, the rice is amazing.
The cabbage gives it a nice little crunch. Nice crunch.
Yeah. like that.
And we're gonna come out. So look up, I got you. And it's not getting edited. That might actually go viral. I didn't hear that part. What are you eating, bro? First off, where is this? What's the name of this restaurant?
First of all, it was amazing.
Uh huh. What is it? It looks. It's
smoking.
Guys, it's like a donut with pretty pebbles on it.
First of all, it's a waffle.
It's a waffle. One at a time, hold on.
It's Moki Bar, which is like a Japanese-style ice cream that they mix with the waffle mix, and then they make it into a stick, like a waffle stick. Mine's just called the unicorn stick, which is with condensed milk and fruity pebbles. And Kaden has a s'more, which they put a load of marshmallow fluff on top, and then they torched it. You missed that with the vlog. They torched it.
Mm.
And I'm making a mess over here, but it's so good. You want some?
Can I have a bite?
Now you're making a mess. It's like you switch hot green. Which one do you think is better, Dad? Which one?
I don't like marshmallows.
You don't like marshmallows?
I don't.
What?
I didn't expect the banana pudding to have such a chill to it.
Yeah,
we think
it's
the best. Must
best,
yes. Yeah. So what I have here, guys, is from this vendor called Bananas. Bananas, they're a local vendor in Jersey City. They haven't opened up their location yet. But what they have here is called the OG. It's the original banana pudding. And it's made, it has a nice whip taste to it, it has a nice chill to it as well.
And they have cookies and cream too.
They have cookies and cream.
What else is like
on? Strawberry.
Strawberry.
He's about to order the Callahan's burger.
So it's the Captain Crunch chicken fried burger. And it's a chicken
glaze, right?
It's like the ground glaze of this chicken. And
baby, on our way to see what's the name of the movie?
Saturday Church. It was freezing. I had to change my jacket. I had to go home, change my jacket, put on a scarf, because I was out here thinking that it was springtime, but it's freaking cold. We just had 60 degree weather yesterday, and now it's back to like
freezing.
30. Yesterday was amazing. Oh yeah, my god,
the weather was great yesterday.
So I'm gonna see Saturday Church. Cadence manager Lisa Callie's son Luca Kane is starring in this movie, and it's basically like I can't remember what I'm trying to say, but it's basically like, I don't want to say low budget, but what do you call those films, Keys?
Short
indie film.
Indie film. Yeah.
So Saturday Church is an indie film, and
I don't know who wrote it. I don't know who directed it. I just know that Luca's in it, and it's about Luca plays a character who basically transgender, and Saturday Church is where he goes to like meet others like him, and you know, he basically is like a teenager. He's coming of age, and his family is very strict, and he has to be like the man of the house because I believe his father just died. I just know the backdrop of the story from what I saw online, but I'm excited to see the movie.
Yes.
And we're freaking cold, but we're almost here.
Breeze.
So we'll talk about the movie as we get out. Look at Luca. Hi, Luca.
Oh, babe.
Thank you so much.
Yes, man.
Thank you.
See you.
Thank you, man.
Good. How are you? Thank you. Pleasure.
Dominique, nice to meet you. Okay.
India.
Hi, India. I'm Dominique. Nice to meet you. Oh, thank you.
Yo, really amazing things are gonna happen.
There's not gonna be that many people in there, so bring it on.
Good. I'm not taping nothing. I'm not inside. I'm not getting kicked out.
Listen,
oh, thank you. Nice to meet you. Bye.
That shopping in your mom.
Oh, wasn't it funny?
I used to do that with my ass.
We'll see you tomorrow, Lisa. All right, love you.
Find out for sure.
So that was Luca, the star of the show. I didn't expect to see them.
Great to see them. Right?
I didn't expect to see them, but you can go inside. But it was great to see them. All right, I'm so excited. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.
Hey guys, so we are finally finished watching a movie. I enjoyed it. I cried.
It was a great movie. Definitely was a good movie. A little different, but you know, I have a new higher respect. You know what I mean? Because
for the transgender
community,
LGBTQ community.
Not that I had anything personal against anyone. That's not the type of person I am. But at the same time, you know,
just higher regard, knowing what they go through. Like you actually see, like
the struggle they go through. Yeah. You know, the downfall they go through. You know,
especially as being like a black male. Misunderstood and not just
not being accepted. You know, I think that's what there's a lot going on in this country as far as racism, people not being accepted, people being bullied. Like, I put that all in the same tree in a sense.
A lot of people are prejudiced towards
the LGBT. That's exactly what I'm looking for.
It was very intense. It was a very intense movie. Like I said, I cried. It was just crazy seeing Luca, like, that out in that perspective. I was just like, he did an amazing job. And whoever did the makeup, Luca was, he was beat.
She looked at me like I was going to say, yeah, he was beat. That wasn't happening.
He was beat.
I wasn't going to say all that.
At the end. Oh,
but
Luca,
he definitely did a great job.
I was like, wow.
Just, you played that character. You played that character.
I want to tell everybody, just go out and see it. You can download it.
There we
just
go.
Just try to go out and see it.
Name of the film is Saturday Church. Looks like it was at the Tribeca Film Festival. Best Actor Award.
He's won some awards already for it.
So we expect this movie to go big.
Yeah, absolutely.
We expect it to go big, man. So definitely support. Lisa Cali, you're amazing. We love you. Thank you for the continuous support with Kaden, Diggy's World, and to see your son on this platform is such an inspiration. Congrats again, guys.
To the next, and we didn't bring Kaden because it was not a film for kids, so that's why I was like an adult only night.
That was Lisa's idea,
don't bring Kaden, it's a little bit too much. So, you know, it is for adults. It's not rated, and I would definitely say, you know, even like, I would say teenagers, because a lot of teenagers go through what the character went through in the story, and he was a teenager himself. So I think like a lot of teenagers need to see it. I would definitely say like 14 and up, because at that age is when you're starting to come into yourself and starting to know what you like and what you don't like. And it's a good movie for teachers to start at teenage age, and then, you know, for adults.
And it, you know, as kids getting older, it's something that we can't hide from our children anymore. It's something...
we can't hide from our children anyway. So as he get older,
from our children,
just speaking a generation. We can't hide this from them because they need to see this. They need to know what's going on, so they won't either be prejudiced or have that ill will against anybody who, you know, going through changes in their life when it comes to like sexuality. So. Long time noodle garden, baby. Chinatown.